Good morning, dear students. In the chapter Protecting the Environment, we have discussed about the types of pollutions, like that is air, land, water and soil, and what are the main causes or the reasons for the getting these pollutions, and even the prevention of this pollution or how you can reduce the pollution. In today's class, we will be learning about waste and waste management and its methods of disposing. So basically, students, we use lot of things in a day. In our day-to-day activities, till the morning until we go to the bed, we use lot of things. It may be the kitchen. In the kitchen, the waste of the kitchen items or the leftout food or the any eatables things and the things which are left out after preparing the food, and even with the puja items, it may be, or the any unwanted machinery items, tools which you are using while cleaning the home, and such like we will be using daily, and fruits, and where does the peel go, the outer skin of the fruits which we after eating after having, and when it comes to your stationery, when we sharpen the pencils, where does the pencil shavings go, and when we drink soft drinks, as I said, maybe the cool drinks and the plastic bottles especially which we use for the drinking purpose. So all those things have been used by us, and once we are using, after that where it goes, do you think so, what it happens? So they're telling, as we use all those things, they all go in dustbin as waste altogether. This is the mistakes we does. So all the things we use and all the things after the usage of it, we just throw to the dustbin where it is been kept, and sometimes we also doesn't use the dustbin also, I think. So the things that are not of our use anymore are called waste. So what is waste? So students, the things that are not of any use, from those things we are not will not make use of anything, it will be not usable for further usage, it is called, we call it as waste. Again, these waste have been divided into two types, which are the biodegradable and non-biodegradable. So biodegradable and non-biodegradable. So waste are those things which are not of any use from those things. Again, these waste have been used for the biodegradable and non-biodegradable. So what do you mean by biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste? Let me see. So let us see the meaning of biodegradable waste. The things which you are using easily get rot and get mixed with the soil, and such as, for example, leavings, paper and vegetable peels are called biodegradable waste. In simple, we can say the things which are easily get mixed with the soil and turns out into manure is called biodegradable waste. It does not require lot of time to get mixed with the soil, whereas biodegradable waste are those it takes many years to get mixed with the soil and to get in turn into the manure, and thus remain in the environment on the surroundings for the longer time, are called non-biodegradable waste. So basically, the things which are of not use in further usage is called waste. These waste have been classified into two. One is biodegradable waste and another one is non-biodegradable waste. Biodegradable waste is nothing but the things which get easily mixed up with the soil. The waste which is going to be mixed up with the soil easily without any longer period of time is called biodegradable waste. And the things which are not going to get mixed with easily with the soil and it remains for many long years in order to convert those things or the waste into mixed with the soil is called non-biodegradable waste. So this is the biodegradable, non-biodegradable waste. Then plastic, aluminium are some examples of non-biodegradable waste. It takes time to mix up with the soil, lot of years to convert those into the soil. These are the examples for the non-biodegradable waste. So when the waste is not disposed, so as we as I said, waste has been classified into biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. So when you're segregating or making separation, are we segregating it properly? No. Because of this only we are getting, the environment is getting polluted. Causes air pollution, land pollution especially, and even the air, land and noise pollutions, and even the soil pollution is also been. Due to this noise soil pollution or the land pollution, what happens? The animals which are getting the, which once we throw the waste in the open land area, the same thing will be, the animals will come in search of food and they will grab it and they will have the same thing, and it causes harmful for the life of the other living beings also. And these causes for living such things, the such waste on the open land will causes the air pollution also, which will be harmful for us living beings to breathe, and we will not get proper oxygen. So when you are segregating, when you are disposing, when you are throwing the waste to the dustbins or the where the place is being kept, we should dispose it or we should throw it properly. This is called waste management. When the waste is being managed properly by us, is called waste management. The managing of waste in proper way is called waste management. So when the waste is not disposed of properly, it causes pollution. Obviously, it causes pollution. Thus, we must collect, treat and dispose of our waste properly. So when the things is brought in the right manner, and the same way the dispose has to be go in the proper manner, correct? So the practice of collecting, treating and disposing of waste properly is called waste management. Only the usage is not is enough. Is dispose and it's a getting rid of it's the waste things also is very, very important. Otherwise, it is going to be harmful for the environment in which we are living. So there are some ways in which we are disposing or getting rid of, or we are throwing the waste. What are the methods? Basically, dumping. This is the first we will be doing. Dumping of waste in an open area in the outskirts, wherever the open area is being there, where the people will never used to go over there, less number of people will be there, where during traveling or on the way when we go, you just dump the cover of the cover which is filled with the waste, all the waste, household waste or any other waste, we just dump into the open area. This is one method we are doing. And second method, landfill, dumping of solid waste in deep ditches. Ditches is nothing but an pit-like area. It will be there in that open ground. We will be throwing all the waste and we'll cover it with the soil. One is dumping and the other one is landfill. And third one, if it is filled with large number of waste, what we'll do? We'll collect all those waste. It includes dry waste, wet waste, and even the plastic, and even the some minerals resources like aluminium, coals, like electronic devices also, it will be there. All we'll do, put it at, we'll gather all at one place, and we just put a fire on it, and it will get burnt. But after burning, the smoke will releases, it's a bad air which is harmful for us to breathe, and the smoke, and it pollute the air also. So lastly, what we do, compositing, collecting the biodegradable waste which can easily be mixed with the soil without taking longer time in a pit, and covering it with the soil to form a manure. This will be used for the agricultural activities also we can use, and soil is also not going to be harmful. But whatever the methods we are following, that is dumping, landfill, burning, compositing, is not the right way they are telling. So because each method has got their own way of disposing. We have to segregate the dry waste in wet waste, and all the glass pieces or the plastic and the which is non-biodegradable before throwing it to the, following these, all these four: dumping, landfill, burning and compositing. So dear students, what in today's class what we learnt is, what is waste, what are the kinds of waste, and how it is been disposed and thrown away. In the next class, we will be studying about other three R's which will be helpful in saving our environment, and we can say our the how the waste can be utilized in a different manner. That is three R's. Thank you. Please go through the video. We'll have a discussion on this topic in the live class. Thank you.